I recorded, that's the coffee maker. I recorded a different kind of Dharma talk before this, but then I recorded the practice and it was kind of a disaster because my dog is all over the place and my son's all over the place. And I was starting a little bit to get frustrated with that, but the whole purpose of this practice was to discuss perspective and choices and how we respond to things. So in the midst of my practice, I thought, man, what a great lesson happening as we speak. I started this practice with a quote that I'm going to continue, and it goes as follows. It's from Joseph Campbell. Hold on a second, baby, okay? It's from Joseph Campbell, and it goes as follows. We're in a free fall into future. We don't know where we're going. Things are changing so fast. And always when you're going through a long tunnel, anxiety comes along. And all you have to do to transform your hell into a paradise is to turn your fall into a voluntary act. It's a very interesting shift of perspective. And that's all it is. Joyful participation in the sorrows and everything changes. And that's a great lesson. It is a good and necessary choice to make. And we all have the power of that choice. We can't control, we can't always control the things around us. We cannot always control our situations. We can control how we perceive these situations and how we respond to them and how we let them affect us. So, in gratitude and acceptance of choice and the choice of gratitude and acceptance, I give you this practice. Imperfect and random as it is, it is a joyous one, which starts at the top of your mat and ends kind of on your face and shifts beautifully through the whole thing, if I do say so myself. So everyone grab their mats, grab their props, grab their waters, grab whatever it is you need to grab, and begin your practice. You've made an excellent choice.
Okay, we're going to start our practice standing up at the tops of our mats. Our feet parallel, grounded into the earth, and hips width apart. You can measure whether or not your feet are hips width apart by measuring the width of your two fists together. It should fit nicely in between your feet. And once you're ready and grounded, with your hands at your side, on an inhale, begin to lift your right arm, circling it up and backwards three times. Inhaling on the lift up, exhaling as you circle it back. Once you've finished your three rounds, move to your left hand, lifting it up and circling it back three times. And once you've finished your three rounds on the left, we will circle now forward on our right, lifting backwards and circling it forwards. Once again, inhaling and lifting, exhaling and circling down. And Once you've finished your three rounds on the right, let's move to the left, circling those forward three times. And once you've finished your three rounds on the left, let's take our arms out to a T, pressing them backwards, finding a nice back bend. And as you exhale, bring your arms forward, crossing them in front of you, embracing your opposite shoulders and hugging yourself. On your next inhale, open those arms nice and wide again, finding that nice back bend once again. And as you exhale, bringing your arms in front of you, crossing them. This time the opposite arm is on top, grabbing your opposite shoulder blades or shoulders and hugging yourself. On your next exhale, you can release, and inhaling, stretching up high to the sky, and grabbing your right wrist with your left hand, lean towards the left, activating the left side body, stretching the right side body, keeping that right foot grounded. And as you inhale, come back to center, release your wrist from your hands, grab your left wrist with your right hand, and on your next exhale, lean towards the right, activating that right side body, stretching the left side body, grounding that left foot into the earth. And on your next inhale, come back to center, stretch up nice and high, reaching for the sky. And on an exhale, circle both arms back and down, hinging forward at the hips and finding Uttanasana, forward fold. Let's hang out here for 5 breaths. And as you exhale, plant your hands into the earth. And on an inhale, step back to plank position. We're going to hold this for 5 breaths, making sure our hands and palms of our hands are grounded into the earth. Our wrists, elbows, and shoulders are aligned. If you want a little extra work here, you can touch your opposite hand to shoulder, so you can lift your right hand up and touch your left shoulder, and then lift your left hand up and touch your right 6 times. That's 3 on each side. And if you finish your shoulder touches or you're still in plank, go ahead at this point and lower to low plank. So lift your right hand up off the earth, bringing your right forearm to the earth, pressing into that, pressing into the palm of your right hand, lifting your left hand up and bringing your left forearm to the earth. And we'll hold low plank for 5 breaths. And each drop of rain goes by in vain. And on your next exhale, you can lower all the way to the ground and roll over onto your back, bending your knees, bringing the soles of your feet to the earth for constructive rest pose. And then lifting your right foot off the earth and crossing it onto your left knee / thigh, kind of making a figure 4 with your legs. Lift that left foot off the earth, bringing it towards your face. Your right arm's gonna reach in between your legs, and your left's gonna reach around your left hip. Grasp those hands together and pull that left leg towards your face. On your next exhale, you can release that left foot back to the earth, uncross your right foot, cross your left foot onto your right knee slash thigh, lift that right foot off the earth, bring your arms around your right thigh, grasping behind the right thigh, and on an exhale, pull that right leg towards your face. On your next exhale, you can straighten that left leg, grasping your right toe with your right piece fingers or with a strap around the ball mount of your right foot. And from here, with our left leg now extended and pressed into the earth, extend your right leg and bring it to about a 45 degree angle, keeping that left hip pressed into the earth. And on your next exhale, drift that right leg back to center, keeping it extended. At this point, lifting the left leg off the ground, bending it, bringing your peace fingers, your left peace fingers around your left toes or the strap around the left ball mount of the foot, and lower that right leg extended, lower it to the earth. Here you can extend your left knee, bringing your leg to about a 45 degree angle. Pressing that right hip into the earth. And on your next inhale, you can drift that left leg back to center, bending it, taking the strap off your ball mount to your foot and releasing your toes. You can bend your knees, bring the soles of your feet to the earth for constructive rest pose. On your next exhale, roll up to a seated position, either propping yourself up on your elbows first or rolling up vertebrae by vertebrae with your arms extended in front of you, rolling over your ankles to find tabletop. Tabletop finds us on all fours with our wrists, elbows, and shoulders aligned, our hips and knees aligned. We're going to begin with some rounds of cat-cow. On your next exhale, drop that belly to the earth, untuck your hips, and lift your chin towards the sky. As you exhale, tuck your tailbone in, sucking that belly in towards your backbone and tucking your chin to your chest. As you exhale, drop that belly, untucking that tailbone, lifting that chin. And as you exhale, tuck that tailbone, suck in that belly, and tuck that chin towards the chest. We're going to do three more rounds of cat-cow. Do it at your own pace, matching your breath to your body movement. Once you've completed your rounds of cat-cow, you can find a point of stillness in your spine. And stepping your hands out about a half hand's length in front of you, tuck your toes into the earth and pressing into them, lift your hips up and back for Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Pressing the palms of hands into the earth like you're pushing something very, very big away. Energetically pressing those heels towards the earth. Give a slight bend at the knee if you want. Pedaling out your feet and holding for a few more breaths. On your next exhale, walk to the top of the mat, bringing your feet to your hands. Inhaling, lifting halfway up with a straight back. Exhaling, releasing into the earth. And on an inhale, curling up vertebrae by vertebrae to find a standing position. Circling your arms back and up for Urdhva Hastasana. Lengthening that body. And as you exhale, circling your arms back, hinging forward at the hips for forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. And as you exhale, plant your hands into the earth. Step your right foot back and then your left to find plank. Lower all the way to the ground, slowly with control. Once you've found the earth, untuck your toes, bring them to the long edges of the mat. Press the tops of your thighs to the earth. And on an inhale, activate your back body for Bhujangasana. Keeping that gaze fixed on the ground in front of your mat. Exhale and release, bringing your toes back to center and tucking them, pressing your palms into the earth and lifting through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Walk your feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release back. And on an inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to find standing. Stretching high for Urdhva Hastasana. And circling your arms back and down, hinging forward at the hips. For Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, plant your hands and step your left foot back and then your right for plank. Lower to the ground, untuck your toes, bring them to the long edge of the mat, press them to the earth, press the tops of your thighs to the earth, and on an inhale, back bend for Bhujangasana. Exhale, release, bring your toes back to center, and on an inhale, lift, pressing your palms to the earth through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Step your right foot up and then your left. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release. Inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to find standing, stretching up for Urdhva Hastasana. And circling back down again. Finding a little back bend and hinging forward at the hips. Forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release into the earth. And once again, step your right foot back and then your left for plank. Lowering down all the way to the earth, untucking your toes, bringing them to the long edge of the mat, pressing the tops of your toes to the earth, pressing the tops of your thighs to the earth. Inhale for Bhujangasana. Exhale, release. Bring your toes back to center. Press those hands into the earth, pressing up through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Stick your left foot up and then your right. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release. Inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to find standing, stretching high for Urdhva Hastasana. And circling back down again, hinging forward at the hips and bending forward for forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, plant your hands, stepping your left foot back and then your right. Find plank, lower. Meeting the ground, untucking your toes, bringing them to the long edge of the mat, pressing them into the earth, and on an inhale, lifting for Bhujangasana. Exhale, release. Bring your feet back to center, tuck those toes, press into the earth with the palms of your hands, lifting in one straight line through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. On an exhale, step that right foot forward and then the left. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release. And as you inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to find standing, stretching high to the sky. And this time, bringing your hands down through prayer. Lift our right foot off the earth. If you have a chair for standing, you can hold onto the chair. And cross it onto your left thigh so that your right ankle's in the space just above your right knee at the bottom of your left thigh. And with your hands in prayer or holding onto a chair, you're going to want to sit back, grounding that left foot, that left heel into the earth as if you're sitting in a chair. And on your next inhale, straighten that standing foot, straighten that left foot back to standing, and you can bring your right foot back to the earth and step back to warrior two, or you can slowly with control, without putting that right foot back on the ground, step it backwards to find warrior two on your left side. So your left knee is forward and bent, and your right is back behind you with your foot to the ground turned at about a 45 degree angle. Your arms are out to a T, gaze past your front left middle finger. And on an exhale, drift that right arm back, reaching over with your left to find peaceful warrior. Inhale, come back to center. And as you exhale, reach down for side angle on your left side. Inhale, come back up to center, straightening that left knee, that front knee. And on an exhale, drift down to triangle on your left side. Inhale, come back up to center, finding warrior two again, and cartwheeling your hands down. Step your left foot back to meet your right for plank, and lower down to Bhujangasana, untucking those toes, pressing them into the earth, activating that back on your back bend, holding it. And as you exhale, release, pressing those palms into the earth, bringing those feet back to center and going up through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Walk your feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release, and on an inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to standing. Circling your arms back to Urdhva Hastasana and coming down through prayer or grabbing your chair on the other side. Ground that right foot into the earth and lift your left, bringing your left ankle to above your right knee. On an exhale, you can sit back, grounding that right foot into the earth as if you're sitting in a chair. And on your next inhale, stand up. Pressing that right foot into the earth, release your left foot to the earth and step it back for warrior two. Or try and slowly with control, bring that left foot all the way back. Finding warrior two on your right side, your right knee is bent, your left leg's extended behind you with your foot pressed to the earth at about a 45 degree angle. Your arms out to a T. Gaze fixed past your right middle finger. Inhale, and on an exhale, drift that left arm back, reaching backwards with your right to find peaceful warrior. Inhale, come back up to center. Exhale, come down to side angle. Inhale, come back up to center. Straighten that front knee. And as you exhale, find triangle on your right side. Inhale, come back up to center, and finding warrior two once again. Cartwheel your hands down, stepping your right foot back to meet your left for plank, and then lowering to Bhujangasana. Exhale, release back into the earth. Bring those feet back to center, press your palms into the earth, and lift up through plank to Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Walk your feet up to meet your hands on an exhale. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release. And on an inhale, curl up vertebrae by vertebrae to standing. Stretching high, high, high up for Urdhva Hastasana. And keeping your arms by your ears, begin to sit back as if you're sitting into a chair. Making sure your feet are parallel, your weight borne in your heels. A slight untuck in your hips, very slight. Exhale, straighten those knees, hinging forward at the hips, finding a forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, press those palms into the earth and either step or jump back to plank. Here you can lower down and do Bhujangasana, or you can do Chaturanga to upward facing dog and then downward facing dog, whatever your flavor of the day is. And when you find yourself in downward facing dog, you can inhale, lifting your right foot up, heel to the ceiling, toes to the ground. And as you exhale, bring that foot into the space between your hands and find warrior two. making sure your alignment on your ankles and knees is all good. Inhale, and on an exhale, lean back to peaceful warrior. Inhale, come back to center and find side angle, this time on your right side. Inhale, come back to center, find triangle. Inhale, come back up to center. And with that knee kind of bent slash straight, we're going to find Ardha Chandrasana, which is half moon pose. So you can press your right foot into the earth, your hips wide, just as they were in triangle pose. Press your right foot to the earth, making your arms out to a T. You can put a block in front of you to land your right arm on if you want. And lift your left leg behind you, finding your block or the ground with your right arm. Keeping your left arm extended towards the sky, your gaze forward or up at the ceiling if you want. Activating your abs, keeping those hips nice and open. And on an exhale, you can step your left foot back to the earth and then walk to the top of the mat. Or again, you can step it down slowly with control, bringing it all the way to the top of the mat without meeting the earth with your left foot. Once you're at the top of the mat with both your feet glued to the earth, press into your left foot, lifting your right. And you can grab your right ankle with your right hand if you want and bring it either to the space by your calf, your sort of shin area at the side, or between your upper thigh, between your knee and your hip. What you don't want to do is bring the sole of your right foot to your knee and press against it, because your knee is a sensitive spot and you don't want to bend it that way. Tree pose. You can keep your hands in prayer or raise them up. And on your next exhale, release that right foot back to the earth, stepping back to warrior two on your right side and circling your arms down, cartwheeling them down to find plank and traveling through your vinyasana of choice. Eventually finding Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. On an inhale, lift your left leg up, heel to the ceiling, toes to the ground. And as you exhale, step into the space between your hands. Making sure your alignment's all good, press those feet into the earth and cartwheel up to warrior two on your left side. Inhale, and as you exhale, drift back to peaceful warrior. Inhale, come to center. Exhale, drift down to side angle. Inhale, come back up to center, straightening that left knee and going back down to triangle. Inhale, lifting back to center and bending that front knee slightly. We're going to press into our left heel, lifting our right foot up, lifting our right leg up, arms out to a T. Left arm landing on either a block or the ground, and find Ardha Chandrasana. Activating your right leg, keeping it active and lifted. This is not just a balance pose working the left leg, it's a full body work. So you want all of your muscles active and lifted towards the sky. On an exhale, you can drop that right foot down or bring it in slowly with control all the way to the top of the mat. Find standing at the top of the mat. And once you're there, on an inhale, ground that right foot into the earth, lifting the left. Bring the sole of the left foot to either your ankle or calf, to a block. You can put the block underneath it too, I forgot to mention that. Or your inner thigh to find tree pose. So again, your arms are in prayer or up above you like little branches. Exhale, releasing that left foot back to the earth. stepping that right foot back to find warrior two on your left side and cartwheel your arms down. Go through plank to your vinyasana, whatever it is. Eventually finding, once again, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. And jumping or walking your feet up to meet your hands. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release, and on an inhale, curl up vertebrae back to standing. Stretch up high to the sky. And on an exhale, with our arms extended at our ears, we're gonna sit back as if we're in a chair once again. And on your next exhale, straightening those knees, hinging forward at the hips for forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, release back to the earth. And planting those hands, step or jump back to plank. Go through your vinyasana. Eventually finding, once again, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Once you're there, on an inhale, lift your right foot up, heel to the ceiling, toes to the ground. And as you exhale, step that right foot to the space between your hands, finding your proper footing, pressing those feet to the earth, cartwheeling your hands up to warrior two. On an exhale, drifting back to peaceful warrior. Inhale, come back up to center. Exhale, drop to side angle pose. Inhale, come back up to center. Straighten that right knee. And as you exhale, lean down to triangle. Inhale, come back up to center. And bending that front knee slightly. We're going to do Arn't Chandrasana once again on our right side. Bending our right hand to either a block or the ground. Extending our left above us. Reaching towards the sky. Right, left leg lifted. On an exhale, drop that foot to the earth or swing it slowly with control all the way to the top of the mat. And grounding that left foot into the earth, bending the right. Find tree pose. Release your right foot back to the earth, stepping your left foot back to find warrior two once again on your right side. And on an exhale, cartwheel your hands down, stepping your right foot back to meet your left to find plank. Lowering down, doing your vinyasana, thinking about how powerful you are, feeling strong, and finding Adho Mukha Svanasana. On an inhale, lift your left leg up, heel to the ceiling, toes to the ground, and on an exhale, bring it into the space between your hands. Find your proper footing, stepping that back leg up a little bit, turning it, smushing your soles of your feet to the earth, and cartwheeling your hands up to find warrior two. On your next exhale, drift your right arm back for peaceful warrior. Come back up to center. Exhale, drop down to side angle. Inhale, come back up to center, straightening that knee. And on an exhale, go down to triangle pose. Inhale, come back up to center. And we're gonna press that left sole of foot to the earth, bending the knee slightly. Arms out to a T, lifting that right leg up for Ardha Chandrasana on the left side. And on your next exhale, you can lower that foot back to the earth and step up to the top of the mat, or just bring it slowly with control in one fell swoop to the top of the mat. Press that right foot into the earth bend. Bring the sole of your left foot to the inside of your calf, the inside of your thigh, the inside of your right ankle. Put it onto a block, hands at prayer, or reached above you as willowy, beautiful little tree branches. Feet rooted to the earth. And on your next exhale, you can release your left foot back to the earth, stepping that right foot back to find warrior two, once again on your left side. And cartwheeling your hands down, stepping your left foot back to meet your right and finding plank. And traveling through your vinyasana. Eventually finding yourself in Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Here in Downward Facing Dog, we are going to pause for a moment, take a few breaths. And on your next inhale, drift forward, lowering your hips down, aligning your shoulders, elbows, and wrists to find plank. Holding plank. 5 breaths, or you can do a shoulder touch again if you're feeling extra powerful. And on your next exhale, drift back, lifting those hips up and back to find Adho Mukha Svanasana again, pressing those palms into the earth. And on your next exhale, stepping your right foot up and landing into the space between your hands, keeping that left toe tuck, your left knee off the earth, your right knee and ankle aligned. And on an exhale, you're going to lift your right arm up, reaching it towards the sky, twisting to the right. Pressing your left palm into the earth, reaching your right fingers towards the sky. Inhaling, lengthening the spine, exhaling, deepening the twist. Your next exhale, bring that right hand back to the earth, finding alignment once again with your hands and wrists and elbows and shoulders. Step that right foot back to find plank once again. Here we're going to hold it, or we can do shoulder touches again if you're crazy. Rubik's cube, let the true genius in. And on an exhale, press your hips up and back to find Adho Mukha Svanasana. Breathe in, and as you exhale, bring your left foot forward to the space between your hands, keeping that right toe tucks, right knee off the ground. Press that right hand into the earth, lifting the left, and as you exhale, twist to the left. On your next exhale, undo that twist, making your left, pressing your left palm back into the earth, stepping your left foot back to find plank, and then drop your knees to the wide edges of the mat, the long edges of the mat, dropping your booty back to your heels for child's pose. On your next inhale, you can drift your body up to tabletop. Step your right foot up into between the space between your hands. And then on an inhale, press the sole of your foot to the earth, press your left shin to the earth, and lift your chest, bringing your hands to your hips or to your ears up above you, stretched up above you. On your next exhale, you can allow that knee to drift forward a small bit, finding the little back bend. Anjaneyasana. On your next inhale, allow that knee to drift back to center. And taking some blocks, or just meeting your hands onto the earth, straighten your front knee so that the heel of your right leg is at the earth and your left shin is still pressed onto the earth for half split. You can hinge forward as much as comfortable to you by walking your hands forward or walking your blocks forward. Blocks are really helpful here because it's a very intense stretch for the back of the leg. On your next inhale, you can walk your hands back or, you know, walk your blocks back and then bring your right sole foot back into the earth. Ditching those blocks, bring your palms to the earth and stepping your right knee back down to tabletop. Inhale, and on an exhale, bring that left sole foot to the space between your hands. Exhale, and on an inhale, sit back up, pressing the right shin to the earth, pressing your left sole foot to the earth, bringing your hands to your hips or up above you at your ears. And on your next exhale, drift that left knee forward, finding a slight back bend for Anjaneyasana. On your next inhale, drift that knee back, grabbing your blocks, using them as little stilts, straightening that left knee so that the heel of your left foot's on the earth, and hinge forward at the hips for half split on your left side. Releasing that half split by walking your feet, walking your palms back, walking your blocks back, bringing the sole of your left foot to the earth, itching those blocks, and bringing the hands to the earth for tabletop. From tabletop, you can sit back onto your heels for Vajrasana, lightning bolt pose. Here, lean forward, bringing your palms to the earth, and walking your palms to the top of your mat. From here, we're going to make sure that our hips and knees are aligned, and pressing our palms into the earth, press our shins into the earth, and begin to bring our chest towards the earth, finding a really lovely and gentle back bend, flaring that rib cage towards the ground. I need you more than I did before. On your next inhale, you can release your back bend, bringing your forearms once again to the earth, and laying your body, your belly on the earth, keeping your forearms pressed to the earth, your palms pressed to the earth, finding Sphinx pose. The tops of your feet are pressed to the earth, tops of your thighs are pressed to the earth, forearms pressed to the earth, everything active. And on your next exhale, turn your arms so that your backs of your hands are in front of your forehead. And you're going to stack either your left hand over your right or your right over the left, whichever is comfortable. And just release your forehead into the backs of your hands for crocodile pose. And on your next exhale, releasing crocodile, rolling onto your back with your legs out, laying onto your back. Body On an inhale, lift your right leg up so that it's pointed, the sole of your foot's pointed towards the ceiling. And with a strap or with your fingers, grab your toes. Put the strap around the ball mount of your foot and find supine split. As you exhale, switch your feet, pulling that left toe towards your face. And as you exhale, releasing that left toe, bringing it back down to the earth, laying on your back. We're going to turn to our sides, to your right side, bringing your right arm in front of you. So the arm that's on the earth is in front of you. Your top leg, your left leg, can be supported by a block, kind of long way, so that the top of the block's at your knee and it extends down your calf. Extend your left leg so that it's straight, if it's not already there. Inhale, and on an exhale, twist to the left, bringing your left arm to a T on the other side. If you want to bring your right hand to the outside of your left thigh to deepen that stretch, that's great. If you also want to bend that left knee and catch your left ankle or foot with your left hand, you can find a really beautiful deep stretch there if you want it. And on an exhale, you can release your hand from your thigh, release your hand from your foot, straighten both your feet out, and untwist. That hashtag wants me dead. And twist to your left. Turning to your left side once again, extending that left leg out, bringing the block underneath your right knee. On an exhale, twisting to the right, bringing your right arm out to a T. Again, you can bring your left hand to the outside of your right thigh. We thought we had the chance. And bend your left knee if you want, catching your left foot with your right hand. And when it gets too complicated, when you can't get to sleep, when the morning seems impossible, select all, delete. Select all, delete. Select all, delete. On your next exhale, you can release your foot, straightening both your legs, untwisting, to find yourself laying supine on your mat. On an inhale, tuck your knees into your chest. As you exhale, straighten your legs, bringing the soles of your feet to the sky. Good old days were mostly bad. But I recall how dark the night got then. Absences could make me glad. Bring the soles of your feet to the earth. So when it's too illuminated, and then extend your legs out and straightening your knees. And we'll drift gracefully into Shavasana. Select all, delete. You can get your props set however you want them. Blanket underneath your noggin, a bolster under your knees,
call attention to our breath. Acknowledging the rhythm of our breathing as it raises and lowers our chest. Feeding our bodies, feeding our minds.
Sachidanandamurtaye Nishprapanchaya Shantaya Niralambaya Tejase Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Sachidanandamurtaye Nishprapanchaya Shantaya Niralambaya Tejase Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Sachidanandamurtaye Nishprapanchaya Shantaya Niralambaya Tejase.
And bringing attention from our breath now to the crown of our heads. Feeling with each breath the skin of our scalp loosen and release, becoming heavy and melting into the earth. Bringing attention to the space between our eyebrows, feeling the muscles of our face as they become heavy and loose and slowly melt into the earth. Bringing our attention now to our jaw, releasing the tongue from the roof of the mouth, and feeling as the muscles of the neck and upper back become loose and heavy and melt into the earth. Carry that attention to your shoulders, your elbows, your wrists, and your hands. Imagining a great warm wave traveling through you, loosening the muscles, allowing them to become heavy and melt into the earth. Bringing attention to the chest and abdomen, loosening any tension in the chest, allowing the muscles and organs to become heavy and melt into the earth. Bringing our attention now to your hips. Imagining as the muscles of the hips and legs begin to loosen and become heavy and melt into the earth, following a great wave of warmth as it travels down your leg, past your knees, down your shins, to your ankles, to your feet, allowing everything to become loose and heavy and melt into the earth. And all you have to do to transform your hell into a paradise is to turn your fall into a voluntary act. It's a very interesting shift of perspective, and that's all it is. Joyful participation in the sorrows, and everything changes. When you are ready, you can begin to introduce small movements into your body, wiggling the fingers, wiggling the toes. And then gradually, larger movements in your arms and your legs. Turning onto your side and finding a loose fetal position on your right side, your knees slightly bent. Using your right arm as a pillow and bringing the palm of your left hand to the earth in front of you. When you feel ready, you can press that left palm into the earth and lift yourself back into a seated position. Keeping your eyes closed for a moment, do a body scan and let's see how your body might feel different than it did when we began. Does your mind feel different? Acknowledge what a difference that one choice made, that choice to do a practice. All you have to do to transform your hell into a paradise is to turn your fall into a voluntary act. You can allow your eyes to softly open.
Thank you for joining me in this practice. The light in me sees and honors the light in every single one of you. Thank you.